What? Really? That cheap? A 270 degree freestanding awning for $649? Huh? Surely that must be a typo. Seeing this on the phone, I decided to pop down and check it out. So I drove down to check it out, expecting it to be crap. But to my surprise, it looked half decent, so I handed over the cash and was put on the 2 week waiting list. 2 weeks later, I got the message it was time to pick up. So I headed on down and loaded it on the ute to head home for the install. Okay, so first impressions when unboxing it was that it was quite a big awning. Well, a lot bigger than what I previously had just with the standard traditional awning. It was relatively heavy. So looking at the specs, around 27 kgs, but the quality looked quite good. So I carried on unboxing and started to prepare to mount it. The awning does come with three steel brackets. They are designed to clip or mount directly onto an aluminium platform rack. Well, I don't have one of those on the ute, so the plan is to do a little bit of a modification and hopefully mount it to my 1200mm canopy. Because of the spacing of the canopy, I probably will only be able to use two of the brackets. They do definitely recommend the three brackets, but we'll get it mounted, see how it feels, hopefully nice and sturdy, but yeah, give it a crack. So my old canopy was playing hardball, so out with the grinder, and before long I had the old canopy off, and then a bit of a play around with how I was going to mount the new brackets. After a bit of playing around, I managed to get both awning mounts attached to the canopy, and yeah, it was nice and sturdy. There are a few videos on the Adventure Kings website that give you a full breakdown on how to install the canopy. I definitely recommend checking that out. It is a little bit niggly when you are lining up bolts and things, so definitely check that out. And I'd also recommend trying to use two people while you're trying to lift it. Yeah, it was a bit entertaining trying to do it all by myself, but we got there in the end. With the canopy installed and a bit of wind around, I thought it'd be a good chance to give the awning a test run. So I took it down to the local park and yeah, set it up. So like, as you can see, super simple to set up. It literally takes, I don't know, 20 seconds, undo the bag and walk it out and attach it, and it's good to go. Today it was pretty windy, so I did install the guide ropes. So with the awning, unlike other ones, this awning does not have any fold down poles. You just have to use the guide ropes to kind of add extra stability to the awning, but they seem to work all right. It held up beautifully, and yeah, I was surprised actually. I was impressed. It's for the price, I was not expecting it to be so well designed, and yeah, it seems half decent. Okay, so we'll just run through a few more specs while I show you a few more videos of the awning. So be careful, the price I purchased this was for $648, and however it does fluctuate, you know, Kings, they love fluctuating their prices, so make sure you get it on special. It does go up to about $800. The weight, I said before, is 27 kgs, so relatively heavy, but the bracket system seems to hold it well. It is a single bracket kind of system, so it just folds on that single bracket, and when once fully opened, it has an area of around 8.7 square meters, so a little bit smaller than some of its competitors, but you gotta look back at that price, I guess. It uses a ripstop awning material. I was hoping for a downpour while filming. Unfortunately, that didn't happen, so I'll be interested to see how it holds up in some decent rain. So far with the wind factor, it seems to hold up well, so no dramas with first of all by itself, and then with the additional straps, you know, securing it at those couple points I've got set up. The bracket itself seems well made, well designed. It can hold my body weight, so you know, that's 90 kgs hanging off it. I wouldn't recommend it, but seems sturdy, and yeah. So I have been looking for issues with it. I do want to find, you know, things that I don't like about it, but so far for the price, I haven't found anything that would stop me buying it. I think for value for money, so far, it seems great bang for your buck. If you have got one or you have got issues with yours, please make sure to put a comment below. I would love to hear about it. But so far, for like I say, I've only just set up at the park, looking to definitely test it out on a few trips coming up. But so far, so good. Well, that's going to wrap up this kind of initial review of the Venture Kings 270 freestanding awning. Conclusion, great bang for your buck, well designed. Seems like it's going to last. And yeah, to be honest, I couldn't really find anything to fault it this early in. But like I say, I'll keep testing it, keep putting it through its paces, and we'll see where it fails. But yeah, would I recommend purchasing it from what I've seen so far? Yes, definitely. And yeah. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, like normal, please hit that like button. Really helps the channel out. And if you want to see similar content, please hit that subscribe button. Thank you very much. Have a good one.